Yeah, it's finally here.
Uh-oh.
This is it. Simply Steph.
Yeah, yeah.
Treasures of the heart. Philadelphia's finest. Loving relationships. It's going down, y'all. By my wife, Stephanie Dion Johnson. Hey, baby, y'all. Let them know what's going on.
I've been working hard to see that everyone else is okay. So tell me, where can I go to find rest today? Mother, wife, entrepreneur, nurse, employee, and friend. Man, does my long list of responsibilities ever end? Heavy load I must maintain, not to mention the stress. So tell me, my beloved, where can I go to find rest? My day begins early, while everyone else is still asleep. You know this busy woman has a rigorous schedule she must keep. Much weighs heavily on my performance, more or less. So tell me, my beloved, where can I go to find rest? I work diligently for endless hours at a time. How in the world do I keep from losing my mind? Cooking, cleaning, washing, ironing, and raising babies too. Working classes, kids stuff, and traveling, just to name a few. And I must adjust enough energy to make time for you, sweetness. So tell me, my beloved, where can I go to find rest? By the week's end, I'm exhausted and drained, yet duty still don't cease. So is it too much for you to demonstrate some care and concern for me? I've admitted I'm human too, and I've let you lay your head. Now, can a sister get some rest and perhaps a little breakfast in bed? You can drop the kids by the sitters and prepare a meal or maybe two. Just think how much smoother life would be with a little help from you. I'm human, I get weary and worn, and sometimes experience bitterness. So in my time of need, beloved, where can I go to find rest? I'm aware your load is heavy to bear, and sometimes you need to vent. But I'm proposing we learn to support one another without a heated argument. I've communicated what is on my heart, and I hope it is well received. And I pray my beloved, whom I care deeply for, will be a place of rest for me. Yeah. a lot about you guys and often tend to criticize. But this one is not about you, because we girls know we have flaws too. We're sometimes too demanding and everything has to be our way. We forget that you too have needs and that you too can have a bad day. When things go wrong, and they do, we expect you to figure it out. We expect you to read our minds because we think that's what love's about. We always cry you're not sensitive, but when you try, we're still not satisfied. We tend to be complex creatures. I'm not exactly sure why. We say that you're all dogs and you're no good, but women, you know we creep too. And when we do, we find a clever way to charge the blame to you. This may be the perfect opportunity, or at least a chance at redemption, to offer apologies to good men everywhere for some things we failed to mention. Perhaps Adam and Eve can unite, and Adam can lead the way. After all, God made Adam the provider and Eve the purpose of a helpmate. Now that we've laid it on the table, you decide what you'd like to do. But women everywhere, let's admit that we are human too. To keep my home intact, yet the media is always on my back, showing negative images of the black man down and out, rarely spotlighting the ones traveling the right route. Yes, some have been misguided by the turf they've been shown and found the grass not so green on the other side. But what about the ones who by the laws we abide and who strive each day to live our lives right and keep our families tight? Dedicated family man, hard working and intelligent, building for our families with the day far spent. With my head held high, I will fight through the storm, and for justice I will strive and cry out loud. By any means necessary, protecting my family, because I am black, strong, and proud.